Now I'm making some modifications to it. That was actually put on there upside down. That's just the bottom. So I don't need it to be really tall. So we're gonna add a riser on top like we did with the small one. And we've added some caulking around the edge to kind of fill in that fillet a little bit. There might actually fill it there. So hopefully that'll help it come out of the sand without breaking that edge off.
Forgot to let the fuel turn on last night. We siphoned 5 gallons of diesel out overnight, so it's in that pipe and now it's heating up. My bed engine's gonna flash here pretty soon.
Down a little bit on your side.
Okay.
There you go. All right.
Come on, girl. There it comes. There it comes. Oh, it took everything we had.
Yeah. Okay. All right, that is called spalding. That's because we had that bucket of dross sitting on top there too long, and it went bang. Bucket went up into the air a little bit and came right back down. So the trick is, these high density concrete pavers, they do fine. Sand, rock, gravel, anything other than concrete takes an immense amount of heat, but concrete, not so good.
Hope it fell off.
Center it up nicely.
Coming up in the riser. Alright. Ready? Look. Just a little fire.
Okay, so we still got our problem here, and even now it's even close to where we were pouring through. There's the riser and the gates for the feed, and then this is the other riser we put in. It did draw from it some. No problem here, a little bit of problem there, and big problems here, and especially there. So what we're going to try and do is put a chill bar in next, which is a piece of steel that will draw the heat out of this area and hopefully pull molten metal across while these things are still liquid enough. That's the idea anyway. Okay, that didn't work. Now what has worked today is making it pull the last of the hot metal right through the area where it draws from when it shrinks. So I think this area is cooling down. It's drawing from here. So what we're gonna do is we're gonna fill this, and then we're going to keep filling metal into here through this part, and that way should pull it back down and draw from there and fill in the gaps when that cools. worked on the roller, so it should work here too. So simple to add on, and hopefully that works. Yeah, and then we broke this off today. Something else we learned is don't mix it into the sand and leave it to sit for a couple hours, because the sand doesn't do anything but latch on to especially things that aren't waxed really well. So it grabs a hold of that and broke it loose. It's not a really big deal. It's just the bottom of a riser, so it doesn't go without it tomorrow. I went ahead and slapped a coat of paint on it last night too, and it always needs a little steel wool to smooth that out. And we used some car wax on here too, but I'm not sure that helped a whole lot. You know, actually, if it breaks a little bit of sand right here and places like that, it just doesn't matter much. It's easy to cut off and grind your part back to where you wanted it to. So, you know, the worst thing is a piece of sand falling off and going inside, you know, creating a big void in there for you. That would be the worst. You know, I think we strive too much in our society for perfection. And especially if you have a YouTube channel, people think, well, it's got to be really perfect. I'm going to put it up on YouTube. That is such bullshit, you know? It just has to be what it is, you know, and perfection is just a waste of time and for, you know, building a boat like this, striving for that. I'm reading a book right now. It's great. It's called The Power of Vulnerability, which means, you know, you don't have to let everybody else control what you think is good. And it's just sad that we've done that to ourselves in this society. We've missed out on so much because there's so many people out there that are afraid to share. So in that vein, I appreciate all the photographs you guys have shared of your projects, you know. Now this is called the core, and it's made of the same stuff we use for the hull molding. In fact, most people only see sodium silicate used for cores. We use it for the everything. And the core just keeps you from having to bore out a whole bunch of metal in the center of this thing. It's where the shaft will run through. We actually left the core out of one yesterday. Fortunately, we caught the mistake. Open the pattern back up and put it in before we poured all that metal in there. Whoa. Here it comes. Oh shit, that's all right, ignore it. Just a little fire. Here it comes. Alright.
But he didn't expect this.
What? Working 5 minutes after he got here?
Yeah.
He should have. He should have. This is Nathan from where are you, what town are you from in Michigan?
Lansing, Michigan.
Lansing, Michigan. Okay, well, it helped, but it didn't fix it. There's still a little bit of hole back in there. And there's a little bit of hole on the other side too. So we're getting closer, but no cigar. We can see it back down in there. Just a little tiny thing, but it's there. So, oh, there's a good shot of it. You can see it underneath that riser. So, I don't know. One more thing we do tomorrow is we're gonna do one more set of this, and we'll take these. We're gonna put them right up here on the biggest chunk of the part, and maybe that'll help. We'll see. Beautiful job. Keep a little faster. A little faster.
Four.
A little faster.
Four.
A little faster. A little faster. There you go. That's a nice piece right there. Hold that flow. All right. Keep going. Keep going.
Oops, got a dog.
There it comes. I see it coming up down there. Keep going. You're filling. You're slowing.
Slowing. You're good. Put that tongue back for you. All right. Now we're going to pour ingots.
Gently. Easy. Stop. There you go. Nicely done.
Not too full.
Nice. How many years have you been welding?
This will be about maybe an hour total.
Here you go. Yeah, we got a lot of brand new shiny welds all the way down up and down the boat. And you feel like a welder now? Would you call yourself a welder on your resume?
You know, depends on how ethical I want to be on my resume.
Oh, I think you should totally do that.
That are hit. Perfectly best.
If it's pretty, it's mine.
But I've got one on either side that's not too bad.
Yeah, he's done good.
Like, I'll get that, going for like mine. 6 or 8 inches, and then it'll fall.
Oh, so were there taps in between? Is that what?
Yeah, the 2 inch, you put 2 inch welds in and then they're overlapped, which is just a practice. It's good for you, but it's not necessary. There's plenty of steel here, so with the heat. Let's go eat.